Hello, anatomists. Michele Glass here, and we're back in our study of the heart model. And what I'd like to do in this particular video is introduce the anatomy of the heart while also talking about the flow of blood through the heart. I think that's a really good way to practice those structures in that context. So you get to practice two things at once. I think then I'll do a third video highlighting some particular features and more specific kind of structures. And then we'll do actually a fourth video that will be the diagram. So we're going to have probably four instructional videos for the heart. So let's get started by reminding ourselves of orientation. So I'm holding this model in the way it would be positioned like in my body. So my right and the model's right are the same, and my left and the model's left are the same. Now, to begin, we see that we have what's called a superior vena cava on the right side. And here at the bottom, inferior vena cava, also on the right side. And so vena cavae, that's the plural form of our word, we're doing an A-E ending, is referring to both superior and inferior vena cava, or cava. These large veins are draining the blood from the body and bringing it back to the heart. So superior vena cava would be from above the heart, and inferior vena cava here would be from below the heart. Those large veins are carrying deoxygenated blood, and so they're shown here in blue. And they're bringing that blood into the right side of the heart, into the right atrium. So the whole right side of the heart is going to be full of what we would consider deoxygenated blood. It's blood that's already been delivered out to your body tissues. Remember, the atria kind of have these like overlaps, and we refer to that as the auricle. So maybe it looks maybe like a big fleshy ear right here to an anatomist. If we pull off that piece, we'll talk more about these internal structures on the third video, but what we can see here is our chamber on the right side of the heart that's going to be holding that deoxygenated blood. So the vena cavae are going to empty into the right atrium. I'm going to go ahead and pull off this portion of our model so we can see then inside the ventricles. We can see that here. And so I still have the right atria open, and now we're seeing the right ventricle. So blood from the right atria will flow into the right ventricle. And then we have what's called a valve that's actually going to close off that passageway when the right ventricles contract. And so this valve right here is called the right atrioventricular valve, which is a really nice name, right? Because it tells us it's in between the right atria and the right ventricle. So I love that name. It's very descriptive, easy to remember. It can also be referred to as the tricuspid, because we'll see it has three sets of these chordae tendinae, which are shown here as these strings. We'll talk more about those in the next video. And so in addition to calling this the right AV, or atrioventricular valve, we can also call it the tricuspid. And if you want to have a memory device, you can say, "I try to be right." And that can help you to remember that the tricuspid is the valve on the right side. As the blood flows from the right atria into the right ventricle, when the right ventricle contracts, it closes off that right AV valve. And as the ventricle continues to contract, it pushes open what's called here the pulmonary semilunar valve. Pulmonary semilunar valve is at the base of this large vessel here called the pulmonary trunk. The word pulmonary is talking about your lungs. So remember, the blood on the right side of the heart is deoxygenated. It's heading to the lungs. It's heading through what's called the pulmonary circuit. And the purpose of the pulmonary circuit then is to get the blood to the lungs so it can deliver the carbon dioxide gas it's picked up from your tissues and pick up oxygen to then deliver fresh to all your cells as needed. So notice that the pulmonary trunk is leaving the heart, so it's going away. And remember, arteries always carry blood away from the heart. So this pulmonary trunk is actually a large artery, but it's shown in blue because it's deoxygenated blood. So this is one of those exceptions to our color coding rule. The pulmonary trunk is going to divide into what are called pulmonary arteries. So you can see it here. If I spin it around, you can see that it's branching here. Now this right here is actually still the right side, so that's called the right pulmonary artery. And this side here is called the left pulmonary artery. It's on the left side. So the right pulmonary artery is going to branch off and go to the right lungs, and the left pulmonary artery is going to branch off and go to the left lung. As the blood goes to the lung, it delivers CO2 and it picks up oxygen. So when it returns to the heart, it's going to be oxygenated. Remember, we use the red color actually to just represent oxygenated blood. Remember, veins carry blood back to the heart. So even though these are red, these are veins. So again, we're going to have a set of left pulmonary veins, and we have a set of right. Here's the vena cava, and so here's the right pulmonary vein. The pulmonary veins bring blood into the top chamber on the left side of the heart, so we call this chamber the left atria. And blood flows from the left atria down into the left ventricle. And again, we have a valve in between the atria and the ventricle. And this valve we can call the left AV, the left atrioventricular, or it can be called bicuspid because there's two sets of chordae tendineae. Or you can call it the mitral valve. So you actually have three choices over here. You can call it the left AV or atrioventricular. You can call it the bicuspid, or you can call it mitral valve. So here in this lower chamber, this is the left ventricle. So blood flows from the left atria through the left AV into the left ventricle. As the left ventricle contracts, it closes off that left AV. As the left ventricle continues to contract, it pushes open what's called here a semilunar valve. And this is at the base of the aorta. So we call this valve the aortic semilunar valve. The aortic semilunar valve gets pushed open and blood goes out the aorta. And you can see it shown here in red because everything on the left side of the heart is oxygenated blood. And this is our artery. So here we see that consistency where we have arteries always carrying blood away. That's 100% true. And we see our typical pattern of arteries having the red color because they typically carry oxygenated blood. When we look at our aorta, we have the ascending aorta. We have the aortic arch, so that's the curve around. And then as it starts to go back behind, as it starts to come back behind the heart, we would call that the descending aorta. As we look at our ascending aorta and aortic arch, we see that we have three major vessels, three major arteries that are coming off there. So this artery here, this first branch, and it's shown here closest to the superior vena cava, the first branch is called the brachiocephalic trunk. Brachio is talking about your arm, your humerus, remember. Cephalic is your head. So this is called your brachiocephalic trunk. The next significant branch that we see here is your left common carotid. Left common carotid. And then this last one that we see here is the left subclavian artery. Left subclavian artery, so clavicle, as in your collarbone. I'm popping mine out there. I've got too much stuff in the way. Yeah? Okay. So clavicle, clavian. So that's your left subclavian artery. Okay. So let's do a quick run through of the flow one more time. So we have deoxygenated blood from the body being delivered to the heart through the superior vena cava or cava, and inferior vena cava or cava. And that blood gets deposited into what's called the right atrium. From the right atrium, blood flows directly into the right ventricle. It's passing through that right AV or tricuspid valve. So if I'm practicing my anatomy and my physiology, I would say from the right atria through the tricuspid valve to the right ventricle. When the right ventricle contracts, it pushes open the pulmonary semilunar. From the pulmonary semilunar, it goes out the pulmonary trunk, and then it goes out the left and the right pulmonary arteries to the lungs. At the lung, it picks up oxygen, so now all of the blood on the left side of the heart will be shown in red to represent it's oxygenated. So color coding here can be like super helpful. When we talk about blood coming back to the heart from the pulmonary circuit from the lungs, we have a set of pulmonary veins, and because the blood is oxygenated, here's where the veins are going to carry oxygenated blood and be shown in red. So remember, again, we're going to have, this would be the left side, and this would be the right side. Right side is in line with the vena cava. Okay. When I open up this part of my model, I can see into my left ventricle. Blood flows from the left ventricle through the bicuspid valve, mitral valve, left AV valve, into the left ventricle. And now I think, did I say it right? So right atria, left atria, left AV, left ventricle. I think I did that. Yay. Okay. From the left ventricle, aortic semilunar valve, ascending aorta, aortic arch, descending aorta. Branching first off of the aortic arch, we have the brachiocephalic artery, left common carotid, and left subclavian artery. All right, so stay tuned for the next video. And as always, take care of yourselves and each other.